Good afternoon, my dear brothers and sisters.
Good afternoon, Father.
We include in this Mass our personal intentions. And we pray for the birthday of Chelsea and Cheska Tarobal. We also pray for the special intention of Rebecca Siriaco, Michi Elbo, and Julie Vergara. And we also remember in this Holy Mass our departed brothers and sisters for the souls of Atenogenes, Elisa, and all the souls in purgatory. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit,
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. You were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. Almighty, ever-living God, who govern all things, both in heaven and on earth, mercifully hear the pleading of your people, and bestow your peace on our times. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the first book of Samuel. Saul took 3,000 picked men from all Israel and went in search of David and his men in the direction of the wild goat crags. When he came to the sheepfolds along the way, he found a cave, which he entered to relieve himself. David and his men were occupying the inmost recesses of the cave. David's servant said to him, "This is the day of which the Lord said to you, 'I will deliver your enemy into your grasp. Do with him as you see fit.'" So David moved up and stealthily cut off an end of Saul's mantle. Afterward, however, David regretted that he had cut off an end of Saul's mantle. He said to his men, "The Lord forbid that I should do such a thing to my master, the Lord's anointed, as to lay a hand on him, for he is the Lord's anointed." With these words, David restrained his men and would not permit them to attack Saul. Saul then left the cave and went on his way. David also stepped out of the cave, calling to Saul, "My lord, the king." When Saul looked back, David bowed to the ground in homage and asked Saul, "Why do you listen to those who say, 'David is trying to harm you'? You see for yourself today that the Lord just now delivered you into my grasp in the cave. I had some thought of killing you, but I took pity on you instead. I decided I will not raise a hand against my Lord, for he is the Lord's anointed and a father to me. Look here at this end of your mantle which I hold. Since I cut off an end of your mantle and did not kill you, see and be convinced that I plan no harm and no rebellion. I have done you no wrong, though you are hunting me down to take my life. The Lord will judge between me and you, and the Lord will exact justice from you in my case. I shall not touch you. The old proverb says, from the wicked comes forth wickedness, so I will take no action against you. Against whom are you on campaign, O King of Israel? Whom are you pursuing, a dead dog or a single flea? The Lord will be the judge. He will decide between me and you. May He see this and take my part, and grant me justice beyond your reach. When David finished saying these things to Saul, Saul answered, Is that your voice, my son David? And Saul wept aloud. Saul then said to David, You are in the right rather than I. You have treated me generously while I have done you harm. Great is the generosity you showed me today when the Lord delivered me into your grasp and you did not kill me. For if a man meets his enemy, does he send him away unharmed? May the Lord reward you generously for what you have done this day. And now I know that you shall surely be king, and that sovereignty over Israel shall come into your possession. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Responsorial Psalm. Have mercy on me, God, have mercy.
Have mercy on me, God, have mercy. Have mercy on me, O God, have mercy on me. In the shadow of, for in you I take refuge. In the shadow of your wings, I take refuge, till harm pass by.
Have mercy on me, God, have mercy.
I call to God the Most High, to God my benefactor. May He send from heaven and save me. May He make those a reproach who trample upon me. May God send His mercy and His faithfulness.
Have mercy on me, God, have mercy.
Be exalted above the heavens, O God. Above all the earth be your glory. For your mercy towers to the heavens, and your faithfulness to the skies.
Have mercy on me, God, have mercy. Please all stand. Your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus went up the mountain and summoned those whom he wanted, and they came to him. He appointed 12, whom he also named apostles, that they might be with him, and he might send them forth to preach and to have authority to drive out demons. He appointed the 12: Simon, whom he named Peter, James, son of Zebedee, and John, the brother of James, whom he named Boanerges, and his sons of thunder, Andrew, Philip, Bartholomew, Matthew, Thomas, James, the son of Alphaeus, Thaddeus, Simon the Cananean, and Judas Iscariot, who betrayed him. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Magandang hapon po sa inyong lahat. Welcome po sa Parish and National Shrine of St. Padre Pio. We have heard in our Gospel that Jesus appointed the 12 apostles and designated them. Sila ang mga malalapit na saksi at direktang saksi sa pagpapahayag niya ng mabuting balita. Nakita nila kung paano ginampanan ni Jesus ang kanyang misyon bilang Mesiyas at tagapagligtas. We can see here that when God calls us, He calls us for a purpose. Hindi man tayo perpekto, meron man tayong kahinaan, ay tinatawag tayo ng Diyos. All of us are being called and sent by God. All of us have a mission to fulfill, and that is to share the gospel of Jesus Christ with people anywhere and everywhere in the world. Anong mission kaya ang ibinigay sa atin ng Diyos? Ano kaya ang mission natin sa araw na ito? Ano kaya ang misyon na dapat nating tuparin? Maging mabuting asawa, maging mabuting anak, maging mabuting empleyado, maging mabuting mananampalataya. Ano man ang ating misyon, lagi nating tatandaan na tayo'y mga alagad ng Diyos. Katulad ng 12 apostol, batid at ramdam natin na hindi madali ang gumanap at tumupad sa misyon. Nandun yung ating kahinaan, nandun yung ating pangangailangan, nandun ang tukso. Ngunit lagi nating tatandaan, bibigyan tayo ng lakas ng Diyos. Hindi tayo iiwanan ng Panginoon. God has prepared us for this mission. Kaya nga, anuman ang ating misyon, saan man tayo isinusugo ng Diyos, magagampanan at matutupad natin ang ating misyon when we humble ourselves and surrender everything to Him. Magtiwala tayo dahil lang tinawag tayo at isinugo tayo ng Diyos. Nandun ang Kanyang pangako na kasama niya tayo sa pagtupad at pagganap ng ating misyon sa buhay. Amen.
For your offerings in the envelope, you may drop them at the collection baskets.
Lord, we gather today in your house, we kneel down and pray. We ask for your mercy as we open our hearts to receive your forgiveness, O Lord. Lord, we lift up to you
all stand.
Pray, brethren, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and the good of all His holy church.
Grant us, O Lord, we pray, that we may participate worthily in these mysteries, for whenever the memorial of this sacrifice is celebrated, the work of our redemption is accomplished through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. His death we celebrate in love. His resurrection we confess with living faith. And His coming in glory we await with unwavering hope. And so with all the angels and saints, we praise you as without end we acclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory, Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is He who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
Those who are unable to kneel, please remain standing with reverence.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church is spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope and Gilbert our Bishop and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection and all have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, her most chaste spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen, amen, amen.
Please all stand.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your Church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Peace be with you. Peace. Peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Those who are unable to kneel, please remain standing with reverence.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Now, parang tikang na lupa sa tubig ng iyong pag-aruga. Ika'y pagmamasdan sa dakong banal nang makita ko ang iyong pagkarangal. Dadalangin akong nakataas sa kikamay, magagalak na awit ng papuring ialay, ngunit ako ikaw habang nahihimlay, pagkat ang tulong mo sa tuwin ay taglay sa lilim ng iyong mga pagpak. Umaawit akong bunggala, aking kaluluwa'y kumakapit sa'yo. Kaligtas ay tiyak kung hawak mo ako. Magdiriwang ang ari, ang Diyos siyang dahilan. Ang sa iyo ay nangako, galakyaong makakamtan.
The second collection, which will be done, is for the continuing development of the Paris and National Shrine of St. Father Pio. Thank you for your offering.
Kunit ako ikaw abang nahihimlay, pagkat ang tulong mo sa tuwin ay taglay sa lilim ng iyong mga pagpak. Umawit, umawit, umawit ako.
Please all stand.
Let us pray. Pour on us, O Lord, the spirit of your love, and in your kindness, make those you have nourished by this one heavenly bread, one in mind and heart, through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen. Prayer for intercession to Santo Padre Pio. All together, Padre Pio, Holy Monk from Pietrelcina, outstanding saint of the present era, our bright beacon in this earthly pilgrimage, our sanctuary in times of trouble, holy exemplar of great courage, with you our needs do we confide, as well as our livelihood, our health, and our might. Unworthy as we are, we pray that you concede. Bless and grace us that our lives may be fulfilled From sin may we abstain, in God may we remain. We also beseech thee, servant of the most holy, to instruct us in the gospel, that we may reflect and believe. Our requests are before thee. Our hearts repent, resolving earnestly to not sin again, to always follow God the Father, together with the Spirit and Jesus the Mediator. Amen. Please be seated for some announcements. Una, sa inyong pagdalaw sa Pambansang Dambana, mangyaring pakaingatan ang inyong mga personal na gamit. Hangad namin ang isang matiwasay at maayos na pagbisita sa National Shrine. Ikalawa, mga kapiyo, kami po ay humihingi na inyong kaunting oras at pakikiisa para sa pagsusulat ng inyong mga pangalan at ilang detalye sa ating Pilgrims Information Record Books na makikita sa paligid ng ating mga simbahan. Ito po ay bahagi ng documentation program para sa pagpapalawig ng mga datos at turismong pangsimbahan at bilang alaala din ng inyong pagbisita sa Pambansang Dambana para po sa ating mga balikbayan, OFW at mga kasama niyong foreigners, doon po kayo magsusulat sa International Pilgrims Record Book. Gagabayan po kayo ng ating mga tagapaglingkod. Ikatlo, sa darating pong Martes ay 23 ng buwan, ang araw ng pagpapagaling ng Panginoon sa pamamagitan ni Santo Padre Pio, ang mga oras ng Healing Mass at Healing Liturgy na may paggagawad ng langis ay sa ganap na 9 ng umaga at 5 ng hapon. Kayo at ang inyong mga may sakit ay inaanyayahan. Maraming salamat po at mangyaring panatilihin natin ang kalinisan, katahimikan at diwa ng pananalangin sa loob at labas ng ating mga simbahan. Magsitayo na po ang lahat para sa pagbabasbas na religious articles.
Mga kapatid, manalangin tayo sa Diyos Amang makapangyarihan upang tayo ay maging kawangis ni Kristo sa taimtim na pagdalangin sa tulong ng mga larawan at mga dasalan. O Panginoong Diyos, Ikaw ang bukal ng lahat ng pagpapala at biyaya. Ibuhos mo ang iyong bendisyon sa mga gamit na ito sa panalangin, mga rosaryo, imahen, dasalan na nagpapaalala ng iyong kabutihan, kabanalan at pagmamahal sa amin, upang ang lahat na dumulog at magdasal gamit ang mga ito ay magtamo ng iyong awa at biyaya. Loobin mong tularan nila ang kabanalan at aral ng Panginoon at ang mga santo magpasawalang hanggan.
Amen. Ama namin, sumasalangit ka. Sambahin ang ngalan mo, mapasa amin ang kaharian mo, sundin ang loob mo dito sa lupa para nang sa langit. Bigyan mo kami ngayon ng aming kakanin sa araw-araw at patawarin mo kami sa aming mga sala para nang pagpapatawad namin sa nagkakasala sa amin. At huwag mo kaming ipahintulot sa tukso at iadya mo kami sa lahat ng masama. Amen. Abaginong Maria, napupuno ka ng grasya, ang Panginoong Diyos ay sumasa iyo. Bukod kang pinagpala sa babaeng lahat, at pinagpala naman ang iyong anak na si Jesus, Santa Maria ay nanang Diyos, ipanalangin mo kaming makasalanan, ngayon at kung kami mamamatay. Amen. Luwalhati sa Ama, sa Anak at sa Espiritu Santo, kapara noong una, ngayon at magpasawalang hanggan. Amen. Abaginong Maria, napupuno ka ng grasya, ang Panginoong Diyos ay sumasa iyo. Bukod kang pinagpala sa babaeng lahat, at pinagpala naman ang iyong anak na si Jesus. Santa Maria, Ina ng Diyos, ipanalangin mo kaming makasalanan, ngayon at kung kami mamamatay. Amen. Luwalhati sa Ama, sa Anak at sa Espiritu Santo, kapara noong una, ngayon at magpasawalang hanggan. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may the Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Amen. The Mass has been offered. Go in peace.
Thanks be to God. You.
Give thanks to the Lord. Give thanks to the Lord. Proclaim His name. Proclaim His name. Give thanks to the Lord.